Hi, everyone. It's great to see you back in the math lab again. Mia's bakery has really gotten popular. It looks like Mia has another math mystery for us to solve today. Maybe we can help the bakery again by solving it. It says, here is a graph of my customers' favorite items from the bakery. Looking at the graph, can you figure out which item was the most popular? Of course we can figure it out, Mia. Now that I think about it, I think I've seen a graph like this before. We've already learned about collecting data, which is specific information. We've also learned that a graph is what we use to represent or show data. We used a graph called a pictograph when Mia had her lemonade stand. In this pictograph, we used pictures to represent how many cups of lemonade Mia sold. But the graph in our math mystery doesn't look like a pictograph. Let's go learn more about graphs to see if we can solve this mystery. The graph in our math mystery is called a bar graph. Can you guess why? It's because the data is organized into bars. These bars can go sideways, like this, or up and down, like this. Let's take a closer look at this graph. All graphs have a title. Based on the title of this graph, I know it's going to represent data about people's favorite colors. The colors that people voted on are on the bottom: red, blue, yellow, or green. Here on the side, there are numbers that show us how many people voted for each color. For every vote a color gets, a new box in that column is colored in. Let's practice reading this graph together. Look at the column for red. We can see that red got 3 votes by counting the boxes in that column. 1, 2, 3. Some bar graphs don't have boxes, so another way we can read the data is by looking at the numbers on the sides, kind of like how we measure with a ruler. Let's look at the blue bar. See how the bar stops at the number 4? That means blue got 4 votes. Now it's your turn. How many votes did yellow get? Yellow got 6 votes. We can tell because the bar stops at the line for 6. What about green? Green got 2 votes. Nice work. We can learn a lot about people's favorite colors from the data in our graph. For instance, we can tell that green is the least popular color because only 2 people voted for it. Which color is the most popular? Yellow. It got 6 votes, which is the greatest number of votes. We can also use a graph to figure out how many people voted in all. To do that, we can count all of the boxes if our graph has them. Pause here to find the total number of votes. How many votes did you count? There are 15 votes in all. Let's see if we can use our new knowledge to solve Mia's mystery. All right, Mia wants us to use this graph to figure out which bakery item is most popular. What type of graph does this look like? It's a bar graph. We can tell because of the bars that represent the data. This time, the bars are sideways, but we read it just the same. The items people could vote for are on the side: bread, cupcakes, cake, and muffins. The numbers we use to read the data are on the bottom. One of the cool things about bar graphs is that you can learn a lot before you even count the data. Before we count, let's see what we can learn about this data. Which item do you think is the least popular? Why do you think that? Great thinking. Right away, I can tell that muffins are the least popular because the muffin bar is the shortest. Let's go ahead and find the number of votes for each item. This bar graph doesn't have boxes for us to count, so we'll have to see where each bar ends to read the data. It looks like bread got 6 votes, cupcakes got 8 votes, cake got 7 votes, and muffins got 4 votes. Which item got the most votes? Cupcakes with 8 votes. Did you notice that the bar for cupcakes is the longest? That's another way we can tell it got the most votes. Mia, it looks like cupcakes are your most popular item. You should definitely keep those on the menu since people love them so much. We did it, everyone! We used our knowledge of graphs and data to solve the mystery. Awesome work! Remember, we have all the tools we need to solve any problem. See you next time! Hey, hey.